Korean culture celebration for Korean adoptees and their families. My name is Garrett Redfield, and I will be your master of ceremonies for tonight's event. I think we have a great lineup for you all tonight, and I hope you enjoy tonight's festivities. Afterwards, we will have a delicious all-you-can-eat style Korean buffet, accompanied by traditional Korean music and calligraphy with a chance to win one of the items. Unfortunately, due to technical difficulties, we will not be performing both the Korean and American national anthems, so we will be going straight to opening remarks, first by Ms. Young Jae-un, followed by the First Lady of Maryland, Mrs. Yumi Hogan, Maryland State Senate Majority Whip Susan Lee, and last but not least, remarks by Adoption Links DC board members Amy Mui and Trish Slater. Thank you.
Speech를 못 해왔어요. 그래서 우리 오늘 우리 비리 이사님 따님분이 번역하고 제가 한국말 하겠습니다. 죄송합니다.
Hi, welcome.
We're going to present a little speech. I'm going to translate for you. 안녕하세요. 특히 바쁘신 가운데도 우리 메일랜드 퍼스트레디 유미 허겐 여사가 저희들하고 함께 해주셔서 정말 감사드립니다.
First off, we'd like to thank Ms.
우리 입양아 어린이들을 자녀들을 훌륭하게 키워주시고 그리고 우리와 함께 이렇게 오늘 좋은 시간을 갖게 해주신 입양아 부모님들께도 감사를 드립니다.
Secondly, we would like to thank the parents of all the adoptees for joining us and raising our children so very well.
이 자리는 우리 아이들이 혼자가 아니라 우리가 늘 옆에서 우리 입양아 자녀들에게 엄마가 되어주고 그리고 이모가 되어주고 언니가 되어주고 누나가 되어주고 우리 입양아들과 함께 짧지만 1년에 한 번씩 항상 이렇게 좋은 문화의 행사를 갖기를 저는 원합니다.
Next, we will have remarks by First Lady, Ms. Yumi Hogan.
Good afternoon. This is, I think, this place is the second we are here, but third annual, we have a Korean adoptee celebration. So it is wonderful to be here again. This is third year. Tonight makes the, we are 은영재 회장님께서 말씀하신 she already said that we are so many adoptees families especially who's here organize this all you know 은영재 your Korean women's that member team who's the organizer also DC adoptee link DC for co-chairing this event again and for inviting me. Thank you, part. Then also, also special thanks all family adoptee, Korean adoptee parents bring the daughters and the sons. Thank you so much. I really thank you. Thank you. I mean, you give them, you know, how to heritage teach who they are. Very important. Thank you so much. This is your partnership is very important. Everyone here today, I would like to recognize also Pastor Hyeol Kim. I'm not sure here, Pastor Kim, but thank you for the open for you beautiful church today again, who open also, most importantly, I want to extend my sincere thanks to all of wonderful family with all Korean also who's involved all this adoptee, this link, and Trishy and other all teams. Thank you, you guys all adoptee, also MC. You did a wonderful, you Korean is so cute, right? He knows some Korean. Yeah, he did a wonderful job. And also who's working, you know, he's recognized, I'd like to, with us, Senator Susan Lee, and Matthew Lee, and George Park, and all other, you know, Pyeongchang 회장님, and other Korean who's the distinguished guests here. Thank you so much. You all come join us tonight. Also, I'd like to introduce my staff, Chief of Staff Eun-young Hong here, and Aaron, and Governor GOCI. Yeah, initiative, you know, I think also who's still here, Sue Park, you know, she's Sue Gu. Sue Gu is, she's also communication director, GOCI. Thank you coming join us. Who's still working, all you working on making possible this event? Let's give them all a big round of applause. As the first Korean American first lady, you know, first history of United States, I have used my role to represent both Maryland and Korea. However, like many of you in this room, my story also requires me to find the two balance between remembering where I came from, while also being thankful for the amazing opportunities I have had in this country. I have found that my favorite way to celebrate my Korean heritage in Annapolis is by cooking. Did you know that? My cooking, I put a video, I like to teach the, my, you know, daughter, like second generation, third generation, but small start, Yumi Cooks. You can check, you know, that video, YouTube. I teach because just like your little, our next generation, you can learn about the easy way. But it's not for peasant food, just like where I came from, my mother, my sister, I learned from that. So traditional Korean food and sharing them with my fellow Marylanders and our next generation. Maryland truly has become my second home, but Korean culture will always be a part of who I am. This feeling is why tonight this event is so important for each and every one of us. It provides a wonderful opportunity to spend time with our new communities. Celebrating and learning about the Korean culture and the traditions through a variety of music and the food and the traditional live performance. Throughout the feasted TVs, I truly hope that each of you feels more in touch with the culture of Korean and that you take a few new traditions back with you. Once again, I want to thank all of the incredible partners who have provided warmth and care to our Korean adoptees, raised them with love. Thank you for all your family here. Please enjoy this wonderful evening of food, music, and the performance. Next, enjoy. Thank you. And God bless you.
And now, Mrs. Susan Lee.
Thank you so much. And thank you, my dear friend, Young Eun, for inviting me here to be here at this wonderful, joyful celebration of two great cultures. And particularly, I'd like to thank our wonderful First Lady from Maryland, Mrs. Yumi Hogan. Can you give her a hand, please? You know, every year she has come to this celebration because she knows it's very important. And thank you for always doing that. You are so committed to this wonderful celebration. And it is a great celebration because we're celebrating the cultures of two great peoples, Korean and American. And I think they're the best in the world. And it's so important. Don't you think so? And it's so important that our kids know, like Mrs. Hogan said, where they come from, because it gives them a very strong foundation, a strong foundation of not only being American, but also being Korean. And it also will prepare them to be able to navigate through this sometimes very difficult world, if you know what I mean, because it's important that you know who you are, and you are the best. And you come from two wonderful cultures, American and Korean. And so I hope that you'll be able to learn something here, but also enhance and expand your worlds too, particularly for the children. And for the families who are here, I hope you have a wonderful celebration too. And thank you for all that you did. And for the community leaders that are here today, thank you so much for being a part of this. This is so uplifting, and particularly what has happened in the last week. You know, this is a celebration of love and unity and cooperation. And that's what America is all about, right? All working together. So, but before I go on, I'd like Judge Chung Pak to come up with me. He's another community leader. Can we give Judge Chung Pak a hand here? There are two people we want to recognize. First, we want to recognize my dear friend Young. Young's a wonderful leader. She's so committed to our community, and she's always there when we need her. And you, can you come up here? We want to give you you first. Yeah. Can we give her a hand, please? Yeah. We're making her an official senator. This one, a senator for today. Okay.
Oh, so nice.
Senator Eun here, Maryland senator.
Thank you.
And also, Judge Park, you want to call up the next person that we want to give a citation to?
Jung Soo-kyung. Jung Soo-kyung.
Can you come up here? She must be working out there volunteering. Or, okay. Okay. Oh, here she comes. All right. Hey, give her a big hand when she comes in. Yay! Woohoo! You know, she was out there working, actually. And this is in recognition from our great state of Maryland General Assembly, Ms. Sue Kwang Jung, in recognition of her outstanding contributions in assisting adopted children of Korean descent in our wonderful state of Maryland. Please give her a hand, please. And thank you, Adoption Links, to and all the sponsors of this wonderful event. The United Korean Presbyterian Church, Reverend Cho and Pastor Kim, and all the leaders who are here today. Let's give them a hand. Thank you so much.
Hello, my name is Trish Slater. I'm a board member of Adoption Links DC.
And hello, I'm Amy Moy. I'm also a board member of Adoption Links DC. And we wanted to welcome and thank you all for coming today. This event is in its third year. It's a labor of love. We really enjoy our partnership and working with Ms. Un. I think one of the best things about being a board member and being involved in the community is meeting all of the great people, sharing stories, building partnerships. I'm also a volunteer with Asia Families, which is represented tonight, which is a great organization to help build Korean culture for adoptees and second generation. We also downstairs have a showcase of adoptees, so you can take some of the handouts. We have information on one of our upcoming events with Amore Pacific and Mark Jacobs on September 22nd. Also downstairs is information on one of our adoptees who please vote for her session at South by Southwest. It's on genomics in a sea of societal issues. So there's handouts downstairs with information on how to vote. But one of the great things is being able to support and build a community for adoptees and with Korean Americans. So thank you so much for coming and really appreciate all of you guys taking time out of your busy day.
For our first two performances, we will have Korean name writing by calligrapher Kwon Myung-won, followed by Didin Se Megadrum performed by Jinu Kim, Christopher, Jisun Yoon, Lance Yoon, and Jiun Jung.
안녕하세요.
네.
제가 영어로 나는 트랜슬레이트 해줄 거고요. 성경 구절 중에서 이사야 43장 4절에서 나오는 말씀을 준비했습니다. 오늘 아침까지 고민을 했는데요. 아침에 제가 4시쯤에 새벽 기도에 이제 가려고 준비를 하다가 갑자기 이 말씀이 떠올랐습니다. 보배롭고 존귀한. 그야말로 우리 어린이들 또 어린이들을 케어하시는 부모님들 얼마나 고배롭고 존귀합니까? 그래서 그 말씀으로 위로를 해드리고자 말씀을 준비했습니다. 한번 써보겠습니다. 이사야 100장 이사야 43장 4절.
He's actually writing from the Bible, Isaiah 43, chapter 43, and verse 4. It says, precious and honorable to all of you guys. So, that's why he's writing. I guess a precious to your kids and honorable to your parents. If you want to watch him closer, you can close to him, so he doesn't mind.
King James. You know, Korean is a little bit different principle from there.
So just as a reminder, this is a verse from the Bible from Isaiah 43:4, and it means, since you are precious and honored in my sight.
That's the digital signature.
네, 끝났습니다. 오베롭고 존귀한 여러분 축복합니다.
어떻게 가야 되지? 어떻게 가야 되지?
근데 이게 다 들어가나?
나는 들어가.
Next up, we will have Asia Families volunteer and fellow adoptee, Joy Gabriel, talk about his trip to Korea and his Asia Families experience, followed by Sogun Jung, a Korean dance directed by Soo Kyung Jung.
So you don't know me, my name is Joey Gabriel. I've been with Asia Families for about 10 years. Actually, this summer was 10 years. I received the Asia Family Scholarship, which is an honor to receive. So this was Asia Families back camp. This was Camp Rice back in 2010. There was like, I don't know, 100 people maybe. And then this is Camp Rice last year, so it's probably tripled the size. It's nice to see a lot of new people. There's new people every year. So I never fully appreciated what Asia Families has done for me until I went back to Korea in 2014. That's me outside of Eastern with my sister. And then that's me with my foster mother. And then my sister with her foster parents. That's me outside the hospital I was born at. And then I got to meet the medical chief of the hospital, which is pretty cool. This is me at the DMZ. We actually got to cross over into North Korea. We got to go through the blue building. You get to walk over. And then this was me getting a haircut. I learned that the barber pole isn't a barber shop. It's something else. You can look it up at home. Asia Families has been an important part of my life. I've been coming since it started back in 2009. I'd like to thank Grace Song. I don't think he's here. No. She's helped me a lot. She's been an important part of my life. That's about it.
Now we have the dancers perform Sogun Jung. Thank you. Now I would like to welcome Adoption Links board member Trish to present on her experience at the park dedication to the Paju Memorial, followed by our last performance of the evening, a Korean dance called Hwasong Mugo.
Hello.
Hi.
Excuse me if I'm a little bit nervous. So tonight I wanted to speak about a personal experience I had going to Paju, South Korea, last year. I'm one of the many adoptees who went to Omukun Park last year. It was the official park dedication in September of 2018. I wanted to share some of the photos that I took and just maybe even answer a couple questions if anybody has any, hopefully not. Omapum Park is a really pretty 16-acre park in Paju, South Korea. And you can tell on my wonderful map here. It's north of Seoul. It's actually close to an old military base, United States military base. So the memorial park is actually dedicated to the approximately 200,000 Korean adoptees that have been adopted out worldwide. So there at the park there are meaningful sculptures. There's a seating area, and it's just kind of meant to be a peaceful place for adoptees to go. Alright, so I personally think that this park was really symbolic for adoptees. I think it's also very important that it was located physically in South Korea. So the word Oma means mother in the Korean language in Hangul. The Korean word "pum," it symbolizes the love and comfort of being in a mother's arms. The Korean artist Moon Sook Kim, she created this beautiful bronze sculpture called Shadow Child, and that's in the memorial park. So it's in the memorial park. I put the link there in case anybody is interested in looking up the rest of her art. It's just really, really pretty. We gathered in Korea and we were bused to the park location. I think it looks different now because I think there might be a gate. But this was the entrance of what we saw. So at the dedication, there were government officials from the city of Paju and also from Korea, which was kind of neat to have them there. All right, well, while we're on this slide, I'll just tell you. Dr. Estelle Cook-Sampson and then Stephen Thatcher, who is they're both also Adoption Links members. They were at the park dedication, and you see them there. So in the background, in the picture to the upper right, one of the organizations that was involved with this park is called Me in Korea. It's a nonprofit organization. They asked for submissions, and people submitted their photo. Most of us have our names in Korean, and they displayed them at the park dedication. I think they had about 650 adoptees that had little plaques, which was kind of neat. It's also very moving. So there were also Korean adoptees on the Hapa tour, and Hapa means half Korean, half something else, like half black, half white. And they are on the Me in Korea adult tour. And they were there dressed in hanbok, so it was really, really pretty. So that's them at the park dedication. And then another organization called 325 Camera, they are dedicated to helping get adoptees tested for DNA and possibly reconnecting them with their birth families. They're also a nonprofit organization. So they were there. So some of my personal reflections, there were definitely a mixed bag of emotions. I was happy to see the park, especially in Korea, and especially dedicated to Korean adoptees. That was pretty cool. I was also sad to think about the separations that have occurred over the years. Lots of physical separations as well as cultural separations. And it also made me think about all the folks who are searching, or still searching, and some of the ones that have passed away, both families in Korea as well as here, that they might not know their family member has passed. So think that's the last slide. Here we go. All right. So if you want more information, meinkorea.org /adoptivevoices. Okay, thank you.
And now we will have the Korean dance called Hwasong Mugol. Thank you all very much for coming tonight, and thank you to those who gave the opening remarks, performances, and presentations. Prior to moving downstairs for dinner, we would like to invite everyone to the front for a group photo.